In this series of video, I am going to tell you some of the basics I wish I knew when I just started. I can assure you that they will really help your first steps in your DJ career. Even if you're an experienced DJ, you will be surprised by how many things you are missing. Hello guys, I'm DJ Wolf from Wolf Entertainment, and today in the first part of this series we are going to cover 2x4 in total sections of personal development, skills and music library management. At the next episode we are going to cover the third and fourth section, which are image and attitude. Yes, attitude. Besides of the knowledge you will get, I'll also have a special gift for you, so stay until the end of the video to find out. I am an active DJ and event organizer in the music industry for more than a decade. After a lot of unforgettable moments, many wins along with a lot of mistakes, maybe more mistakes, but who really counts? I have a ton of great content that I want to share with you in order to help you become a great DJ. This video is mostly for beginners, but even experienced guys will find some useful content to level up their career. Make no mistake, you are not going to learn how to do the specific things we are going to talk about, but which these things are and how they can help you in your DJ path. If you also want to learn how all of these things can be done, you only have to tag along me on this course with the videos that are going to follow. So, subscribe to my channel and hit the bell button as I post at least 2 videos per month with tips, tutorials, performances, reviews and other useful things that every DJ is going to need in his way sooner or later. With no more delays, let's get started. First, we are going to talk about the basic skills you need to have if you want to be considered as a DJ. And yes, you need to have skills. Your controller has a sync button. This doesn't mean you can rock the crowd. Just for the record, I am not a sync hater. I actually use it in a lot of different techniques. And no, it's not a cheat. It's just evolution in technology, and it is useful if you use it in the right way. So, in the skill section, we are going to talk about 2 different types of playing as music entertainer. At the end, that's what we are: music selectors and DJs. The difference is that music selectors play songs one behind the other without any fancy tricks. They select the music just like radio producers, which is a huge accomplishment by itself. DJs, on the other hand, select the music but also try to blend it and make new things out of it with a lot of different techniques. Selectors, in most of the cases, have more free time in their sets. Personally, I don't believe that any of these 2 types is better or worse, because in the real environment of a club, you need to master both types. Why? It's simple. A good DJ is a master behind decks and can rock the crowd. A great DJ is maestro behind decks and also find time to make contacts even when DJing. This is where the selector side takes an important place. So be a DJ to win the crowd with your skills and be a selector to win the crowd's heart. You have to be part of the crowd, respect them, and believe me, only amazing things are going to happen to you. You can't even imagine how many gigs I got just because when I was DJing, I dedicated some of the time to make contacts with people who got professionally interested in my sets. Spoiler alert for the attitude section. Before I started DJing, I was feeling like the king of the club when I knew the DJ. I'm sure you know that feeling. This is how much power we have in the clubs. Use it wisely. Okay, so what do you need to know to be considered as a DJ? Let's assume that you have a music library. As a DJ, but also as a selector, you have to know your music. You know what they say, less is more? That's exactly the case right here. It's way better to have 100 songs that you know them upside down than having 1000 songs that you only know parts of them. It will only confuse you. It might even lead you to make some mistakes while playing a set. In my case, I have fallen in this trap of getting thousands of songs for no fucking reason more than 3 times in my career, and every time I say, "What the fuck are you doing, dude?" It's an absolute nightmare to have to delete thousands of songs you have no common ground with. More of this in a little bit in the music management section. Master at least 2 basic techniques of mixing for every genre. Yes, every genre has different techniques of mixing. Welcome to our world, guys. You play house and techno? You have to be master with the equalizer, the filters and effects. You play hip hop and pop? You have to know at least basic scratching, wordplay and ways to cut fast between songs. I can analyze for each genre different ways to mix, but it will literally take hours, and that's work for more videos to come. Next skill you need is the basic understanding mainly of the gear you use, but also the standard club equipment. So far, the most common club equipment is the Pioneer's CDJs, but it's very possible in the near future Denon's Prime series will go on top. Who knows? The only certain thing is that at some point in your career, you will have to play in the club equipment, so be prepared. I don't have to mention the importance of knowing your gear and how it works, but also be able to use all its features. Also, it would be great to know how to fix small things like knobs, faders, buttons, etc. It will save you a lot of money in the long run. At the end, it's a huge plus to learn all the basic cables, inputs, outputs, and how to connect all of these. One of the best tips I can ever give you is to always have backups, as many as possible. Your cables, second small mixer, second laptop, second sound card, even your music. Yes, you are going to carry more things, but believe me, it is worth it. Be sure that's the worst thing that might going to happen in your greatest gig. So be ready to overcome. One more thing you want to consider is the DJing software. There are a lot of those out there, but the main are 4. Rekordbox, Virtual DJ, Serato and Traktor. Of course, you have to master one of them, but it would be nice if you are familiar with all of them. Sometimes in your career, you are going to need it. I actually work all of them because, you know, I am a DJ instructor, so it's literally my job to know them. But also each one of them has its own strong point. So depending on the project I work at, I choose which one fits my needs. If you are not sure which software is the right one for you, don't worry, I've got your back. One of my next videos is the comparison of all the main softwares, and I will suggest which program fits for every type of DJ. So you know what to do. Google it. Google it. Google it. Google it. Now, let's talk about music library management. As we already said, less is more, but be careful. You have to be prepared for every single one of your gigs. In every other job, they check your skills in the interview, and if you are good, they hire you almost forever. Well, guys, when you are a DJ, things are not exactly like this. Every time you play, it's like an interview, and every single time you have to achieve your best performance. And believe me, it's a hard thing to do. If you don't react good under pressure, this job may is not for you. I have a lot of students saying to me that they just can't handle it. Well, that's normal, and the solution is just keep DJing as a hobby, do some home parties, some live stream, and try again in a year or two to do it professionally. The more experience you get, you will be more comfortable and confident. Back to our music library management topic. Now, let's see how you can prepare. Preparing helps you to become more confident, by the way. Other than the obvious, which is practice, is to do playlist all the fucking time. Yes, playlist. I can't mention enough the importance of making playlist. First of all, by doing that, you also learning your music better and better every single time. Then it's a great thing to have the confidence that you already know the songs you are going to play. Funny thing is that most of the times, because of this confidence, you will be able to play whatever the fuck you want at the end. A small tip over here, if you have 2 hours of DJ set, your preparation playlist must be at least 4 hours. Always make playlists with songs that are twice the time of your actual DJ set programmed time. Like this, you will never get short out of songs in a gig. It's super important to prepare music, equipment and backups, learn things that you may need and a bunch of other things. Although you have to know that sometimes everything will go wrong. You can't do anything about that, it's just the way it is. You will feel so fucking bad, but don't worry guys, you are not alone. Just get over it. What about the library management software? All the programs have their own library management system. Some are better, like Rekordbox, and some are worse, like Traktor. The easiest thing to do is to use your software's library, but it's not the smartest thing to do, according to my experience. Here is where the iTunes app holds the crown. Don't worry, it works both for Mac and Windows. Until 2020, it's the best app to use for your music library management. Why? Smart playlist and flexibility. Smart playlists are the most powerful thing if you actually learn how to use them, and you will save a lot of time with the organization of your music. Nowadays, almost all software have something like that, but they are not even close to the power of iTunes. For instance, Rekordbox has it. They just call it Intelligent Playlist. The problem is that they have less options, and even worse, they have a limit of 128 of them, which is ridiculous in 2020 to have a limit like this. But what can we do? Actually, if any Pioneer guy watches this video, please make the Intelligent Playlist unlimited. If you do so, then maybe we don't actually need iTunes. Not so true, but you know. Let me explain to you a little bit what smart playlists are and why they are so powerful. They are playlists that auto-update depending the tags of the songs. You put the criteria and they do all the hard job for you. Hard job, I mean that they fill the songs in the right places automatic. Even in multiple playlists, you just drop the song in the collection. You can't even imagine how useful this is. Damn! Even now, I can't believe how much I love them. They are so fucking smart and playlist. Oh, just figure out why they call them smart playlists. Because, you know, they are smart and playlist. Damn! Okay, let's move on because I can speak about how smart they are for a stupidly long period of time. The second great thing about iTunes, except smart playlist, stop it, Wolf! Stop it! Is that it's compatible with most of the DJ software. This means that whatever playlist you make in iTunes, you can see it in your DJ software. Let's say I use Serato for all my gigs, but my next one is in a huge festival, so I have to play with CDJs. If I don't use iTunes, I have to recreate all the playlists in Rekordbox to export them in a USB, which is extremely time consuming, obviously. The only thing I have to do if I use iTunes is to open Rekordbox, go to the iTunes tab and export whatever I want from there. Now, the downside is that in the first time you need a lot of time to create all the smart playlists because you have to put a lot of criteria and do a lot of combinations for better results. Also, it doesn't transfer hot cues, play count and other useful information. Well, I can't help you with the infos, but for sure I can help you with the smart playlists. Over the years, I made a super strong library composed by more than 250 smart playlists, with a huge amount of choices inside, like genres, decades, rating system, energy level, key, last ADI, dances, top 100, acapellas, and more. I will provide a link in the description, which you can buy the template to use it with your own songs. Of course, if you have any questions of how it will work with your own songs, you can ask me in the comments below. Right now, as we talk, there is a new program in the trends that is like iTunes, but way much better. It's called Mixo, but it's still in beta version. I am a beta tester, and it's great because it's specifically for DJs. It will also transfer hot cues, play counts, color, and all the other important info that we need, synchronizing our library across software and devices. Easy and fast. It's the fucking dream! As soon it will be ready for use, be sure I will do a deep review, so subscribe to my channel to stay tuned. Another golden tip for your library is to delete whatever songs you haven't played at all. Which I have a ready-to-use smart playlist in my collection for this. Nowadays, it is so easy to find whatever song and download it, or even stream it through Spotify, Tidal, BeatSource, and many other streaming services. That said, you don't need to have all the songs of the world in your library. As I already said, the third and hopefully last time I did that fail, I had more than 40,000 songs in my library, but wasn't play even the half of them. After 6 to 8 months of cleaning and organizing, maybe more, now I try to keep it under 10,000 songs. It helps me to keep things clean and organized. Don't misunderstand me, you can have as much songs as you want, but out of your DJing library. Which brings me to the last tip for this video. Keep separately libraries for DJing and the music you like to listen at home, except if you are DJing only with the music that you love. Then please let me know how the fuck you do it in the comments below. Okay, enough for this video. We already said a lot of things, but we didn't analyze any of that. Don't worry, I will analyze every single thing we talked about with separated videos. So, make sure to subscribe to my channel and turn on that bell button so you don't miss anything. If you feel that you learned something today, give me some thumbs up and let me know in the comments below if you have any other ideas which I can create more episodes of this series. Now, for the gift we talked about. I already told you that you can buy my ready-to-use music library template for iTunes, but I will make an exception only for this series of video, which you can get it for free.
Free!
If you have any questions of how to use the template, again, you can ask me in the comments below. Thanks for watching and see you in the next episode.